What's up, Farmington? We're back with another episode of Tiger News. I'm your boy, Willie Storms.
And I'm Skylar Jones.
Now, my favorite part of Halloween is getting candy. However, there may be some devastating news about my favorite type this year.
A chocolate trend took over the buckets of many trick-or-treaters last Halloween. This year, though, your bucket might be mainly gummy candies. This is due to the 8% jump in the price of chocolate bars. Hershey's and Mars are increasing their prices due to the shortage of cocoa butter, the butter that creates that yummy feel in your mouth. But don't worry, you can still expect plenty of candy.
Now, a restaurant in the UK may be haunted? Allegedly, this is true. Manager Tony Dooley said he discovered a ghost in the UK's oldest restaurant. Dooley went to check the security camera footage after a recent break and discovered a ghostly figure was the cause of all the damage. It appeared to be floating in the air. Dooley stated that skeptics are allowed to have their own opinions, but he was the one that had to clean up all the broken glass. Anyway, skeptics have recreated this video with editing software, but Dooley stands firmly to his belief.
Do you already have your costume picked out?
If not, then I'm here to help you. Party City recently published its top 10 costumes sold already in the month of October. Number 1, Frozen's own Elsa and Anna. Coming in a close second is Gru's Minions. Number 3 is Black and Bone, straight from the grave. Other notable costumes that made the list were the classic nerd, an assortment of superheroes, characters from the popular Disney show Monster High, and of course, the ever-magical Disney princesses.
Now, are you going to host the most memorable Halloween party? Well, as we know, no party is complete without great food. If you'd want to be the coolest around, better be serving up some of these spooky snacks. Dead man's finger food sandwiches may sound exotic, but are really just PB&Js all rolled up with some almonds for fingernails. Spooky ghost cakes are just as they sound. Make white cupcakes and see how fast they disappear. Freaky fingers may not sound delectable, but what they really are hot dogs rolled up in breadstick dough. If you need any more ideas, just go with regular food and give it a creepy name. Now, guess what, Farmington? Random Questions is here, and the answers are almost as strange as the questions.
What do you seek for in a Halloween costume?
Me? A type of majestic one. That's a majestic level. Now, why do you wake up in the morning?
I barely do.
Now, this week on Random Questions, we have a very, very spooky segment, I would say.
Something odd happened to us.
Please roll the film.
It's time for an extra spooky episode of Random Questions, FHS. Let's go.
All right, Willie, you want to go to the lunchroom first?
Yeah, let's do that.
Okay. It's hallway's kind of creepy. Yeah. It's dank in here.
You get that feeling being watched.
Yeah.
Same.
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Let me white balance on you really quick.
All right.
Oh man, Skylar, behind you.
What?
The thing is in a sheet.
What?
Oh, man.
What is that? What is that? Okay, I think we lost him.
Right here, let's go by hand, let's go in here.
Let's just go back to Touchy's room.
Oh man,
we're going back to Touchy's room. We made it. We made it. Mr. Touchy.
What?
Out in the hallway, there's a thing.
Did you get Random Questions done?
No, Mr. Touchy, you don't understand.
There's a thing.
But Mr. Touchy! No!
Okay.
We gotta get this done. We gotta get this done.
Okay, so see people in the lunchroom and then let's go. I don't think he's. Oh man.
Oh god. We gotta go. Do you believe in ghosts?
No.
Well, hold me. Edwin, do you know what's happening?
No, I do not. And...
Oh, man.
Okay. All right. Okay. Where do we go?
We go for the stairs. Go for the stairs.
If we can, I think if we get to the concert hall.
We're safe in the concert hall for some reason.
That's just what we believe right now.
Oh wait, awesome. Dude, wait.
Do you guys know if this place is haunted?
Yeah, it actually is. Ask Mr. Toshi.
Oh, it's right over there. Oh god. Oh man.
Okay, we made it to the concert hall.
Oh my god. It's locked.
It's oh no, we gotta go around.
Oh man.
We gotta go. Is anywhere safe?
No, there's nowhere safe here. Help!
Oh yeah. Okay, we're in the concert hall. My shoe's untied. I'm scared. We don't know where the ghost is. I don't know what to do. I still gotta film random questions. What was that? Oh, there's this. There's something over there. Can you see it? What is that? We gotta get to the exit. Willie, we gotta get back to the room. There's no way we can do this.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Let's go.
Let's go.
You think we need more people? More questions?
I don't. Let's just keep going. I don't. Let's just go. We can just. We'll just show what we filmed for random questions, so that the whole school can see what happened. People need to know, man. People need to know.
That was quite a spook. Now we're gonna toss it over to Levi for the weather. Levi.
Ooh, here's your weather for today. Today we have a high pressure system over Canada. Just got out of Minnesota, bringing cold air, which is why you should wear a parka today during Halloween. Then we got a low pressure system over on the East Coast, bringing colder air to Minnesota, then bringing some snow. And in Michigan, heavy snow. Ooh. But again, it's still warm in California. Ooh. And the desert. And there's storms. Now, here's your daily weather forecast for 5 days. Today, a high of 42 with a low of 20 degrees. Brrr. Saturday, a high of 45 and a low of 32. Brrr. This week, very brrr and cold with highs in the 50s and 40s, low in the 38. And 32. Ooh, on this day in 1991 in weather history, a strong low pressure system brought very cold air and brr, which brought also 1.5 feet of snow to much of Minnesota. While California is still warm, it's cold here. Why do I live here? I still wonder that question. Why can't my spirit be lifted and brought to somewhere tropical? Now back to you, Willie.
Thanks, Leave. I wasn't funny. Okay. Thanks.
The segment of which we do not speak of is next.
What? Classiest class.
Yeah. Let's get this over with.
Okay.
Well, hello, Farmington. It's time for another edition of Classiest Class. This week, we are going to Mr. Lund's first hour, his biology class. Can they hoist the chalice that the poster of Classiest Class? Let's find out. Come on.
Well, hello, Mr. Lund's first hour. How is everyone doing this morning? Doing pretty good. All right, so you've all been chosen as a candidate for Classiest Class this morning. Hello, Ms. Stout's first hour drama. You know what I will need from you? I will need 5 volunteers.
I volunteer!
Now, could I get 4 artistic volunteers? 4 artistic, this is not how it works. Someone has to raise a hand or come up or...
Don't be a wimp.
No one? I mean, we can just leave right now. I mean, that'd be cool.
Just have one pick for
it. We got 2 right there.
We have 2?
Thank you for volunteering.
All right. These 2 right over here. All right. Can we get 2 more?
2 from the north side.
All right. You 2 in the back. You 2 in the back with the Crocodile Dundee. All right. All right. Okay. So I'm going to give you 4 of your tasks in a minute, and I need, while I'm out with them, I need 5 people up here to answer questions. I'll be back in a minute. You 4, come with me. Follow instructions this way, outside, to the class, out of here. I'm going to have you 4 people do. I have 4 sheets of paper right here, and what you're going to do is you're going to draw a corner of Mr. Lund's face. All right, so someone's going to have the top left, top right, bottom left, and bottom right. You're going to have top left, top right, bottom left, bottom right. You each draw a corner of their space, and we're going to try to push it together and see how it looks, all right? Here's 4 sheets of paper. I assume you all have writing utensils. Good luck to you. May the odds be ever in your favor. All right, now, so can you please tell me why Mr. Lund's first hour is the classiest class?
Because we are the awesomest class and the most amazing, he told me to say.
Awesomest isn't a word, but I'll go with it.
Because we never really get a lot of homework.
Because he plays music.
Because there's lots of experiments and labs.
We listen to ancient music and work with random stuff all the time.
Work with random stuff?
Yeah, a lot of.
Classy random stuff?
Mm-hmm,
classy random stuff. All right, sounds like good. All right, I think we're gonna get our 4 people back in here for the challenge that they did. And what what they had to do was they had to each draw a corner of Mr. Lund's face, and then it was going to come together in one portrait. And I didn't see any writing utensils out there, so apparently they're inscribing with their fingers and blood, I guess. All right, have them come back in here.
They need a minute.
They need a minute. So what are we learning about today, Mr. Lund? What are we doing here in your first hour of biology?
Today these guys are trying to figure out if changing an external temperature is going to change your core temperature. So we have some little computer lab quest things that they're going to collect some data on, plunge their bodies into a ice bath.
Do an ice bath.
Yeah, we'll see if they get hypothermia or not.
Get hypothermia or not. It is pretty classy. I mean, not yelling is pretty cool. Some ice. Stick my hand in there. This is the stuff they're going to put their hands in.
Oh, they're done? Oh, darn, I was about to stick my hand in a bucket of ice. All right, so now can you please present to the class your face of Mr. Lund?
I'd say that's a pretty accurate representation.
How about you guys? I think that looks pretty good. Now, what inspired you to create this piece?
I don't know, I guess.
Mr. Lund.
His face.
Yes.
Mr. Lund's face, he has quite a beautiful face. Present them with the chalice.
Yeah.
With a poster of Classiest Class. Congratulations, Woo! Mr. Lund's first
yeah!
hour.
Yeah!
All right. Yes, most noise you've made all hour. All right, here we go, Mr. Lund.
Champions.
May the odds be ever in your favor. Well, thank you to Mr. Lund's class and to myself for being enthusiastic. But it was very fitting with the Halloween theme that they were zombie-like.
Yeah, it's almost like they were all dead. They didn't talk at all.
I know, it was very clever. I didn't get it at first. At first, I just thought they were unenthusiastic.
They must have known it was on Halloween. There's a lot more Tiger News to come.
Do you want a milk?
No, that's all right. Only you.
Do you want a milk?
Yeah. Maybe I'll take two.
Welcome to Brad's Snack Shack.
Mother of God.
That was horrible.
It was beautiful.
What?
That looks really epic. Next week, I also heard we're going to have the Wheel of Death, whatever that is. Brad warned us about it, but it does not seem very good with the Wheel of Death.
I'm excited for cookies.
Excited for the cookies? No, the Wheel of Death is okay, you know, you can just do sports right now. I guess
we're sports is in such an awkward phase. There's no more football. There's no high school hockey yet. That's okay, though. Football is ended, and they lost their playoff game versus Rosemount 56-15 in their highest scoring game of the season. We look forward to seeing what training happens during the offseason to make improvements for next year. The Tiger volleyball team won 3-0 against John Marshall in their first playoff match last Friday. The girls dominated their opponents easily in all 3 games. Mackenzie Hess and Emma Fanning both had 16 kills on the night, helping their team achieve nearly 50 kills. That win gave them the chance to take on Rochester Mayo last night in the Section 1AA semifinal game at Rochester Civic Arena. This was a close match, but the Tigers could not get past the Spartans as they fell in 3 games, 25-15, 25-17, and 25-16. They end their season with a record of 16 wins and 12 losses. Congratulations on a great year. Tomorrow, our Farmington cross-country runners Justin Heitnan and Lauren Peterson take on state at St. Olaf College. Good luck to both of them, and we invite all of you to go watch them run. The Wild took on the Sharks at the XL Energy Center last night. This one looked pretty bleak early for the home team as the Sharks' Joe Thornton scores to give the Sharks a 2-goal lead early in the third period. Then a few minutes later on, the Wild get going by playing Thomas Vanek as he gets it to Brozanek for the tip and the Wild get within one. Then 4 minutes later, Vanek with the speed to Brozanek again and he scores to tie the game at 3. This game would go to a shootout. Miko Kiovo would make a few more moves and scores to tie the shootout. Then it's Jason Palmerville's turn and he moves in and beats the goalie over the glove side to give the Wild the lead. Next, Darcy Kemper could win it with a save. Marlowe states in skates in, shoots, and Kemper makes the save, and the Wild go on to win 4-3 in a shootout. This moves the Wild's record to 6 wins and 3 losses. Pretty good for the first month of this season. However, they still have not scored on the power play. The Wild are 0-26 for the power play so far. If they can get their power play back on track, look out for this team. The Red Hot Gopher football team took on the Fighting Illini on Saturday. They cooled off as they lost a close game, 24-28. Illinois was ahead 2 touchdowns early in the first quarter. Going into halftime, the Gophers cut the lead only to 3 points. They rallied in the third quarter, scoring 3 touchdowns to take a 24-21 lead. However, after a key fumble midway in the fourth quarter, Illinois took on the lead 28-24. The Gophers had several more chances with the ball, but could not handle a pass rush from the Fighting Illini. This makes for only their second loss out of the 8 games played this season. The Gophers get the week off and will play next Saturday, November 8th, versus Iowa at the TCF Bank Stadium. That's all for sports. Let's try to connect live to Joe Senth. He's in the auxiliary gym with the blood drive. Joe?
I'm here with the National Honor Society with the blood drive.
Hey guys, we have our blood drive here down at the auxiliary gym today. National Honor Society puts it together twice a year. We have 120 students that are signed up to donate today, and staff and various community members who are coming in up. We still have some open spots, so if you have some time and you want to donate blood, check with your teachers, and if they're okay, come on down and you can join us.
Yeah, we actually do another drive for those of you that aren't 16 yet and you really, really want to donate. We do another blood drive in May. That's going to be May 6th this year. So towards the end of April, be looking for those signups. And if you turn 16 between now and then, we'd love to have you. We're really, really in need of blood today, guys. So if you can come down today, come get a pass from Miss Johnson or myself.
All right. Thanks, guys. All right. I'm going to go talk to a student now.
Hey.
Hi.
Well, I've done it before, so I found it very exciting to donate. Plus, I don't know if I'm safe to feel generally. Yeah, kind of. It's a new experience.
Yeah.
Well, that's all for today. Back to you guys.
Very, very kind of all of the people giving blood to donate to the Vampires of America. I mean, the Red Cross Association, of course. Oh my gosh, what are your guys' plans for Halloween? I'm going to go out adventuring. How about you, Skylar?
Yes.
Actually, Skylar, I'm actually quite angry at him because we were supposed to do a collaboration costume, and he did not decide to do it.
What happened?
See, he was supposed to be Short Round. You see, I was Indiana Jones, he was going to be Short Round. That's what was supposed to happen. And guess what? He didn't. You want to know why you should have been Short Round? You want to know why? Because you have a cool Yankees hat. That's exactly why.
I believe we argued that you said you were going to be Jake to me being Finn.
Okay, valid point, but... Oh, yes. And Levi is also here with us in the white ghost sheet. That's great. That's wonderful. Thank you, Levi, very much for scaring us during random questions. He says he's not Levi. Okay.
This guy.
Well, I mean, I guess that's...
He's crazy.
What are you guys' plans for Halloween? Where are you going? I'm going trick-or-treating. I don't even care. I'm a senior in high school. I don't give a dang.
I don't even know anymore.
I'm gonna eat some candy.
You're gonna eat some candy. Candy's always good. All right. Well, that's about it for our show today. I'm your boy, Willie Storms.
I'm Skylar Jones.
And I'm Bryn Wharton. We leave you today with artwork from Miss Van B's classes.
Go forth and crush it, Farmington.